and Sri Vivek to start the Sangeeta Saparya.
शरीरं स्वरूपं सदा रोगमुक्तं यशश्चारुचित्रं धनं मेरुतुल्यं गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं कळत्रं धनं पुत्रपौत्रादि सर्वं गृहं बान्धवा सर्वमेतद्धि जातं गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं षडङ्गादिवेदो मुखे शास्त्रविद्या कवित्वं च गद्यं सुपद्यं करोति गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं विदेशेषु मान्य स्वदेशेषु धन्य सदाचारवृत्तेषु सक्तस्थताभि गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं क्षमामण्डले शेषभूपालवृन्दे सदा सेवितं यस्य पादारविन्दं गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं यशश्चोद्गतं दिक्षु दान प्रदापा जगद्वस्तु सर्वं करेयत्प्रसाद गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं न भोगे न योगे न वा वाजि मेधे न कान्दा सुखे नैव वित्तेषु चित्तं गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं अरण्येन वा स्वस्य गेहेन कार्य न देहे मनोवर्तते मे त्वनर्घ्ये गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं गुरोरङ्घ्रिपद्मे मनश्चेन्न लग्नं ततः किं
Yes. That was a very melodious song by Dr. Preeti. This is now Sri Shankara Bhagavata, reflecting the Vedic statement, Acharyavan Purusho Veda. Now I request Sri Subramanian Musa, let your Kandalo
Mudakarata Modakam Sadavi सारकं मुदाकरात् मोदकं सदा विमुक्ति सारकं कलाधरावतं सकं विलासि लोक रक्षकं मुदाकरात् मोदकं सदा विमुक्ति सारकं कलाधरावतं सकं विलासि लोक रक्षकं अनायकैगनायकं विनाशितेभ दैत्यकम् अनायकैगनायकं विनाशितेभ दैत्यकं नताशुभाशुनाशकं नमामितं विनायकम्
That was a melodious song by Sri Vivek. Now I request Sri Subramanian Musath, the secretary of Kanjalu Shala, to welcome.
Yen daira avare kaana pa avare kaana nammal speak cheyada avare kaana.
Good morning to all.
Adha mattana
seri nilla.
It's my pleasure to welcome you all for the Sri Shankara Jayanti celebrations. And in particular, today is Professor Arindam Chakrabarti. Around 10 centuries ago, here in Thiruvananthapuram, southern part of India, existed an ancient Vishwavidyalaya known as Kandalu Shala, with efficient academic procedures and protocols known as Kandalur Maryada, that's rules. Even though it was called as Nalanda of the South, it was much bigger than Nalanda. The present Kandalu Shala is an effort of scholarly world to restore the erstwhile institution with all its glory and tradition. The trust is registered as Kandalu Sabha and initiated the revival of Kandalu Shala, aiming to set up an autonomous private university focusing in higher education and research in ancient wisdom. The 48th senior of Munjara Madam and Pushpanjali Swami are of Sri Padmanabha Swami Temple. But Paramapujya Parameshwara Brahmananda is one among the chief patrons of the trust. And the Swami are is with us today, agreed to be with us today. But unfortunately, he could not join, that's what I learned, to give his benedictory address. In his absence, I am welcoming Swamiji, Paramapujya Swamiji, to this virtual platform with my salutations and Pada Namaskaram. Sri K. N. Narayanan Poti, an illustrious Vedic scholar, also the president of Kandalur Shala and Kandalur Sabha, will deliver the introductory speech. He is my Vedacharya too. He is better known as Narayana Vanivradan because he accepted his Vanaprasthashrama Dharma with all its rituals and traditions. With all my respects, I extend a warm welcome to him. Professor P.C. Murali Madhavan is a scholar of international repute and recipient of Rashtrapati Puraskar and many more laurels to his credit. He is the torchbearer of Kandalu Shala. Kandalu Sabha is fortunate to have him as the special officer of Kandalu Shala. Today's program is his brainchild. I am confident that with his leadership, vision, and commitment, Kandalu Shala will flourish as a center of excellence in traditional learning and application of ancient wisdom relevant to the modern society, with all society. With all my love and respect, I welcome Professor Murali Madhavan to this elite forum. I feel delighted to welcome Professor Srinivasa Varakedi, Vice Chancellor of Kavikula Guru Kalidasa Sanskrit University, Maharashtra. Dr. Varakedi is a recipient of Maharshi Badarayan Vyas Samman Awardee by the President of India, recipient of Chinmayananda Research Gold Medal, recipient of Rajaprabha Puraskar 2020 from Punyani Raja Academy, and many more. He keep himself busy as a member of various national and international academic bodies, editorial boards, selection committees, and as faculty in many institutions. Even with his busy schedule, he agreed to be with us for inaugurating this event. With a profound happiness, I welcome Professor Srinivasa Varakredi for this function. I'm also delighted to welcome Professor Arindam Chakrabarti to deliver the first International Sri Shankara Commemoration Lecture 2021. We are fortunate to have Maha Mahobadhyaya Arindamji with us today. He is a scholar in Indian Darshana systems. He also excelled in contemporary Western philosophy, authored several books in English, in Sanskrit, and in Bengali. His topic of lecture today is Vedanga from Kerala to Kashmir, comparing Shankara's and Abhinavagupta's Advaita. Does Atman, Brahman, Paramashiva have the power to will the universe? Two different interpretations of Ikshana in Brahma Sutra.
Okay.
It will be a great tribute to the great Guru Shankara, Sri Shankara, the preacher of Advaita philosophy. I salute you, Professor Arindamji, and welcoming you to this august audience. Professor C.S. Radhakrishnan of Central University, Pondicherry, readily agreed to be a host and master of ceremony of today's event. He also agreed to give citation to Professor Arindamji. I'm so glad to welcome Professor Radhakrishnan to this event. Namaskaram, sir. Sri S. Madhavan Nambudiri, Vice President of Kandalur Shabha, is an engineer by profession and a Vedic scholar. Dr. Pradeep Jodi is the treasurer of Kandalur Sabha. He is an engineer and management expert. Both of them devoted their time and energy for the upliftment of Kandalur Sabha and Kandalur Shala. I extend a warm welcome to both of them. Pranams. Once again, my wholehearted welcome to each one of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sri Subramanian Mosat. Now I welcome Sri K. Narayanan Poti, the President of the Kandalur Sabha, to deliver the introductory speech. Sri Narayanan Poti.
Namaskaram. Namaskar. Welcome to personalities assembled here that include the viewers entered on the online. President of this event, Dr. P.C. Muralidhar Madhavan, Professor Srinivas Varakredi, and then the main speaker, Professor Arindam Chakrabarti, the dignitary of this ever first International Sri Shankara Commemoration Lecture 2021 organized by Kandalur Shala. And then to Professor Radhakrishnan and other personalities associated with Kandalur Shala and those assembled on online who are interested in ancient Vedic and Sanskrit wisdom, welcome to you all. I salute all of you in the name of Kandalur Shala, an ancient university where students from different countries came and where more than 30 departments existed and thereby had the unique distinction of having the largest number of departments compared to other universities of that time. Here, there was a university that existed 1,200 years before at Thiruvananthapuram in South India, where ancient wisdom and knowledge derived from Veda, Upaveda, Vedanga, Vedanta, and 64 ancient knowledge systems, apart from the philosophies ingrained in Vedic, Buddhist, Jainist, Logathayanic, Kanadist, Vedantic, and Tantric, were taught and applied the methodologies of these knowledge systems for the technological and overall social development at that time. Kandalur Shala occupied a unique distinction as a world university on the academic and administrative management of running an institution of higher learning. For many ancient later universities and Padashalas developed like Parthivapuram Padashala, Kandalur Madhyada, that is the rules of Kandalur Shala, became a role model for conducting a world university. The Hajur plate inscriptions discovered in the 19th century and the disappearing of it along with the Parthivapuram inscriptions at Parthivapuram temple 40 kilometers away from Thiruvananthapuram tell a lot about the method of admission, method of teaching and administration of Kandalur Shala. In Kandalur Shala, successful chanting of two Kramavarams from two portions from Veda without giving any previous clue about the portions to be chanted was the criterion for getting selection for admission to the higher studies in Veda. That too was the criterion of getting selection to participate in Kadavullur Anyonium in North Kerala. In a poetic description of Thiruvananthapuram city written in 13th century called Anandapuram Varnana, we can see the description of the conducting a competitive test, the varams being conducted at Kandalur Shala of Valiya Shala Mahadeva temple just 1 kilometer away from the eastern gate of Sri Padmanabha Swami temple. The Kuvalaya Mala, a literary piece of Ratna Prabha Suri, tells that students from 18 countries studied in Kandalur Shala, who came from Ceylon, East Asian countries, North India, and West Asia. Exclusive subjects in Dhanurveda, 7 special schools of Vyakarana, like Varnam, Vigaram, Agamam, etc., and Darshanam, Mimamsa were taught there. Kuvalayamala tells again that Alekhyam, Gidam, Vadyam, Nadagabhinayam, Nirtam, Natyam, Yendram, Yogam, Yogamala, Yendramala, Macha, Garuda, Jyotisham, Rasayanam, Chandas, Indrajalam, Kaya Karmam, Vishahara Tantram, Bhuta Tantram, Dandakarmam, Nirukhtam were included in the over 30 departments existed in Kandalur Shala. It was a unique distinction. It was not a coincidence that many of the ancient palm leaves manuscripts on rare Shastra subjects, which were not before discovered from anywhere in the world and enlisted as the world famous Trivandrum Sanskrit series by Dr. Ganapati Shastrigal, as curator of erstwhile Travancore, were unearthed from the soil of Thiruvananthapuram city due to the prior existence of Kandalur Shala in this prideful city. In difficult times of war invasions, Kandalur Shala might have given importance to the military sciences, and the very same fact might have compelled it to shift it from different locations around Thiruvananthapuram. And finally, at the time of its peak of excellence, it flourished at the Kandalur Mahadeva temple before its disappearance in the second half of the 13th century. The teaching of ancient sciences and its different methodologies of applications to different epistemologies and to technologies practiced in Kandalur Shala has an appeal on even today. The reason for that is the necessity of searching back and forth into the history of development of methodologies of different logical knowledge systems that constitute an abstract fundamental vision, though knowledge systems develop from lower to higher and then to more higher levels. So the historical approach to the development and application of different knowledge systems is relevant even today. There stands the importance of the revival of a great tradition in which Kandalu Sala excelled in those ancient times. Let me narrate one incident in history which shows the unique position of pride, love, and respect that Kandalu Sala enjoyed. When 1,200 years before, the Emperor of South India, Rajendra Cholan, invaded the Southeast Asian lands, he defeated the King of Java in battle. And when he was asked about his last wish, he said that he wanted an admission for his son, the Prince Apparent, a seat in the prestigious Kandalur Shala, which taught Vedic knowledge and military sciences and even shipbuilding technologies at that time. To get an admission at that time in Kandalur Sala was considered as a prestigious and difficult thing. Actually, Rajendra Chola was humiliated by this request because Kandalur Sala was at that time run by his enemy and rival of Ai dynasty. The emperor, I dynasty that Arundhataka Pallavan at Thiruvananthapuram. This incident shows the love and respect given to knowledge by our ancient forefathers, which helped elevate us to the present status of social development. So we are reviving not only the ancient wisdom and its application to present epistemologies, but we are reviving and imbuing the very spirit, love, and respect for different knowledge systems shown by our forefathers, for integrating all knowledge systems for the application of them to the overall development of humanity. Kandalur Sala is planning to conduct unique courses on ancient texts to dig out the secrets, the philosophical applications of ancient wisdom in the Vedic text. Our first endeavor in that direction is the conducting of 1 year diploma course on the text Kaushadika Brahmanam and a 6 month certificate course on Aitareya Aranyaka, which will be started in the next academic year, the details of which has already been published in our website kandalursala.in. Friends, dignitaries, and educationists, we are here on the threshold of one such effort as a part of organizing the our first international series of lectures, where this being the first one of its kind being organized by Kandalur Sala today. At the most difficult situation of history due to the outbreak of COVID pandemic on frightening proportions, I conclude here by expressing my gratitude and respect to you all for participating selflessly in a fearful situation for a noble effort of upholding the torch of knowledge and wisdom handed over to us by the past, only to pass it to the next generation in a comprehensive form. Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Narayanan Pottiji, for giving a very wonderful account in nutshell of the glorious tradition maintained by the Kandalur Sala in those years, and your great efforts in reviving such a great institution of Vedic learning. That was a very wonderful account of the Kandalur Sabha by you, sir. Thank you so much. Now I request Professor P.C. Murli Madhavan, my senior colleague and a very close friend and present award winner, to deliver the presentational speech. He is the special officer of the Kandalur Sala, and he has been doing untiring efforts in reviving this great tradition. Now I welcome Professor Murli Madhavan to render the presidential speech. Professor Murli Madhavanji.
Thank you, Dr. Alakshan. Namaskaram to all. Shrudesmriti Purananam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Pada Sangaram Loka Sangaram Arudha Praudha Vega Pravijita Pavanam Tunga Tungam Turangam Chelam Neelam Vasana Karatala Vilasal Kanda Kodanda Danda Ragadveshadi Nana Vidham Gapadali Bhitikrit Udabharta Kuruvanna Khedalilam Parilasadumana Kanane Mamagini. First of all, may I seek, or we, the Kandalur Shala, we seek the blessings from Jagadguru Shankaracharya Ji, Shankaracharya, and also our patron, His Holiness Swami Parameshwara Tirtha, the head of the Munjara Madham and the Pushpanjali Swami. The most respected chief guest of the day, Professor Arindam Chakrabarti Ji, a veteran scholar both in traditional and modern lines, whom the academic world qualify as a Darshana Panjanana, my young friend, scholar, a great scholar, international repute, Professor Srinivas Varkhedi, the Vice Chancellor of the Kavikula Guru Kalidasa Sanskrit University, who will inaugurate this first inaugural, this international program. Illustrious Vedic scholar and our friend and our leader, Sri K. Narayanan Putti, Sri Subramanian Musat, Secretary of Kandalur Sabha, Dr. Pradeep Jodi, again the Treasurer of Kandalur Sabha, Dr. Preeti and Vivek, those who performed Sangeeta Saparya, the auspicious beginning of this function. Last but not least, the comparing the great scholar, Professor C.S. Radhakrishnan, a scholar of international repute. I welcome you all. I also welcome my team, the academic and non-academic staff of this great institution, Kandalur Shala. And also I welcome the administrative and academic members of our Kandalur Sabha, the scholars, those who are participating in this virtual platform, dear brothers and sisters. First of all, may I salute you all for making this academic event a meaningful one by your valuable presence. As the chief officer of this great institute, I would like to take a pledge, or we rather, the Kandalur Shala and Sabha, jointly, we want to take a pledge in your presence that we, the academic and non-academic staff and the administrative body of this institute, will revive this institution, will try, work hard, and our level best, we will revive this institution, which will be an attractive blend of tradition and modernity, and which will cater the academic needs of the humanity as a whole. Sri Narayanan Putti has explained the entire history of the Kandalur Shala, so I am not dwelling deep into that. I may be permitted to conclude my presidential observations. Professor Arindam Chakrabarti has expressed his concern about the time, his presentation time, and some deliberations on the paper. So we plan to cut our time, the allotted to the speakers, and whatever possible way, we will do it. As you know, we are celebrating the Shankara Jayanti celebration, and this is the first one, and we luckily got the right person to deliver the first annual international Sri Shankara lecture by Professor Arindam Chakravarti. When we speak about Shankara, there is nothing, no harm. We have to speak a little bit about Shankara. Age cannot wither, nor customs stale the variety of the genius called Shankara. Shankara is the epitome of India. Even after more than thousands of years, the manifold effects of his gigantic impact in the form of commentaries, in the form of Prakarana Granthas, in the form of sweet devotional songs, hymns, are palpable everywhere. He lived only 32 years, but he is scoring centuries in the world of thought, in the world of thought, light, and life. For Shankara's life is the shining example of Indian philosophy and spirituality lived and applied to daily life. Actually, he is the example of religion in action. No intellectual genius before or after Shankara had his scholarship and learning. As a saint and a yogi, he was one of the greatest the world has ever produced. As a preacher, he was the most outstanding. As an intellectual, he was without an equal. As a commentator, he was the most authoritative and the most prolific. Madhusudana Saraswati, in his in the beginning, he says, Vyakhyadrutve bime nasti bhashyakarena tulyata gunjaya kinnu hemnaiga tularobe bi tulyata. So his commentatorship, his vyakhyadrutva, he was the most authoritative and prolific in his commentaries. As an organizer, reformer, and a man of action, he was unparalleled. As a creative writer, when we go through Saundar Lahari, Sivananda Lahari, Achyuta Ashtakam, like that, how he beautifully made a blend of philosophy and the creativity, poetry together in a very most attractive way. As per the creative writer, he is in forefront of all. Dhuristhidaha. If we are to understand this great multidimensional ascetic and appreciate his works, we have to capture an understanding of the climate of thought in which he lived and functioned. At that time, there were various conflicting systems of thought in which he lived and functioned. At that time, there were various thoughts in India, and the condition that prevailed can be best characterized as nebulous. Socially, philosophically, as well as religiously, there was no central rallying point from which men could view the entire panorama of Indian thought. The several systems of thought were narrow and self-sufficient and had nothing to do with one another. Shankara makes a direct reference to the prevalent sects in this time in Dashashlogi. Na Sanghyam, na Shaivam, na Tat Panjaratram, na Jainam, na Mimamsagadayar Matamva, Vishishtanubhutya, Vishuddhatmagatva, Tadeego Vashishta, Shivakevaloham. It was at such a time that the mastermind Shankara set to work to produce unity in the field of religion, culture, and philosophy. We find clearly from a study of Shankara's works that his purpose was to reduce to unity and harmony under the hegemony of Vedanta, the multiplicity of conflicting thought systems without destroying the integrity of the prevalent faiths. He would have brought everything to a dull level of uniformity, but he did not do that. For it militated against his idea of the richness of diversity in the world of faiths. Unity in diversity was his aim and not uniformity. I would like to hear Professor Chakravarti when he was explaining the rather comparing the philosophies of Shankara and Abhinav Gupta, how he will be addressing these points in his lecture, during his lecture. With these observations, I beg to remain. I have Kandalu Shala, the entire team. We are very much indebted to Professor Arindam Chakravarti because he was known to me for several decades. We were together in several other universities. He, on my invitation, he came to Shankaracharya University. Professor Srigala is very rightly here in this platform. She was the head of the Department of Philosophy at that time when I was heading Sanskrit Sahitya in Shankaracharya University. He regularly used to come there and give lectures. He inaugurated a research forum in the Shankaracharya University, which is working very well now. And so I am very much indebted to Professor Chaturvedi, Professor Chakravarti. And also, I am highly indebted to Professor Srinivasa Varkedi. He is a great young scholar with a great vision and mission. He has made Kalidasa University a wonderful institution where both, as I told you in the beginning, that tradition and modernity, they are fused together in a very apt manner, in a very appropriative manner. He is a scholar of international repute and a recipient of Rashtrapati Puraskar. And he was instrumental to get Professor Chakravarti here in this forum. So I once again thank all those who cooperated and participated in this program. With these observations, I beg to remain. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Murli Madhavan, for your presidential speech, where you very beautifully observed about Shankara's religion in action, because it was he who established the Shanmata Sthapaka, as he is revered. Now I request Professor Srinivasa Varkedi ji, the Vice Chancellor of Kavikula Guru Kalidasa Sanskrit University, to inaugurate and deliver the inaugural address and introduce the Chief Guest, Professor Srinivasa Varkedi ji.
With the prayer of Goddess Bharati and Bhagavad Pada Shankara, I declare that this international lecture series is open. Bhavati yadanubhavat edam ukopi vagmi jadam atirapi jantur jayate prajna moolihi sakala vachana cheto devata bharati sa mama vachasi nidhattam sannidhim manasvecha. Shruti Smriti Purananam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Pada Shankaram Loka Shankaram. Today we have Professor Arindam Chakravarti here with us in virtual way, in this virtual platform, who is going to deliver his first international lecture organized by Kantanuru Shala. I confine myself to introduce Professor Arindam Chakravarti in order to save the time. Yes, Kerala is a land created by Lord Parashurama. Just 2 days back, we observed Parashurama Jayanti. Today, we are celebrating Shankara Jayanti. Parashurama created the land, but Shankara gave the name to the land. Acharya Shankara gave the spirit to the land. So that's the beauty of this land. The Kerala land is, of course, land of Prakriti, land of arts, land of knowledge, land of acharyas and land of many learning centers. And of course, today, Kantaluru Shala
Yes, I was mute.
Yeah. After several centuries, this Shala is getting revived with such wonderful events. I'm happy that under the direction of Professor Murali Madhavan and Radhakrishnanji and many other stalwarts of this country, this great project is undertaken by knowledge lovers. On this occasion, as I told, I am greatly honored to introduce my Guru Bhrata, Satirthya, the best brain I have seen ever in my lifetime, Professor Arindam Chakravarti. I should say Mahamahopadhyaya, Professor Arindam Chakravarti. Professor Arindam Chakravarti comes from Calcutta, and he has been trained in philosophy especially in Indian logic, classical Indian logic, Nyaya Shastra, and Indian aesthetics and Buddhist epistemology. After his completion of his undergraduate program and master's in Presidency College, Calcutta, he did his DPhil program. He earned his DPhil from Oxford University, where his work was supervised by Michael Dummett and Sir Peter Strawson. He was serving in US and UK, and he returned to India, to Delhi. He served as professor in the philosophy department in Delhi University. And then he returned to US as professor at the University of Hawaii in 1997. Since then, he has been professor in the Department of Philosophy and Teaching Indian and Western philosophies. In 2018, he occupied Nirmal Agustina Mattu Chair in Indic Humanities at the Department of Philosophy in Stony Brook University, New York. I should say, you will wonder to note his earnings. He earned not only name, he earned knowledge, and he earned lot of contributions to the philosophy. He has authored more than 14 works and published nearly 100 research articles, which are published in peer-reviewed journals of international reputation. More than anything, he was chosen by my guru, Professor Praladachar. If Professor Praladachar chooses someone as scholar, he is the scholar. Never ever I have seen Professor Praladachar just praising someone. And I have seen several times, even today, he fondly recalls and praises Professor Arindam Chakravarti. He is the dearest disciple. Of course, he never calls him as disciple, but Professor Arindam Chakravarti calls himself as disciple of Professor Praladachar. And during his stay in Tirupati, he delivered 7 lectures on Western philosophy, especially on Western epistemology in Sanskrit. Shastrochitaya Sanskrita Gira प्रतीच्य प्रमाण मीमांसायाः नाना विषयान् सह विवेचयामास दैट वर्क इज स्टिल अवेलेबल पब्लिश्ड बाय तिरुपति विद्यापीठ आधुनिक प्रतीच्य प्रमाण मीमांसा वन ऑफ द बेस्ट सेलेक्शंस बेस्ट
not audible
sorry. yeah sorry sorry so this book is still available and it is praised by many Sanskrit scholars and in the last 5-6 years back when I invited him to a workshop organized by Chinmaya International Foundation in Kerala he stayed there for 2 weeks and delivered wonderful lectures very profound, very rich lectures on Ishopanishad. I have never ever heard such wonderful interpretations, taking ideas from various commentaries and his own new commentary. He delivered several lectures, and I should, without wasting much time, I should also narrate. His personality, you know, in these words, Shastra Vada Ratah Kechit, Kechit Arvachya Vadinaha, Arindamoyam Saragnyaha. He never goes into argumentation. He Saragnyaha, Madhya Marga Samashita. He is also good in Buddhist philosophy. Madhya Marga Samashita. Kavishcha Kavitatvajnyaha, Panditascha Philosopher. पंडितश्च फिलोसोफर प्राच्य प्रतीच्य विद्यानां संगमोयम अरिंदमः प्राच्य प्रतीच्य विद्यानां संगमोयम अरिंदमः चक्रवर्ती च शास्त्रेषु भारतस्य शिरोमणिः योजयत् विश्वविद्यानां यो अजयत् विश्वविद्यानां आलयान् शास्त्रमं शास्त्रमंतरा विदाउट एनी शास्त्र ही वन मेनी स्कॉलर्स हार्ट he is a philosopher and he is a poet and artist. Many people do not know that he pens and he paints. He pens and he paints, and he is also a good musician. Today he may not be able to sing, but he is a very good musician that I know. A person like this is very rare and unique. I really am happy to be one of the very known persons to him, and I'm associated with him. Today's lecture, he is delivering on a very rare topic, the relation of oneness philosophy of Shankara with from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. Shankara travels with the philosophy of oneness to Kashmir, and Kashmir also has propagated. Arvind Gupta again propagated Advaita from Kashmir, and he compares these two philosophies today. Over to Professor Arindam Chakravarti.
Thank you very much, Professor Srinivas Vakkedeji, for your excellent way in which you inaugurated this series of lectures, and more so for introducing the chief guest by giving all of us information about such a multifaceted personality as Professor Arindam Chakravarti. We knew him only as a philosopher and in other aspects, but the other aspects of him as very good in painting and music is something that we come to know through your introduction of the great speaker. And thank you so much for your inaugural speech. Before I welcome Professor Arindam Chakravarti, to listen to whom we are all very eagerly waiting, I just request Professor Murali Madhavan to read out the message of blessings from His Holiness Tirthur Parameshwar Brahmananda Tirthaji, who is the chief patron of this Kanthalo Shala. As it was mentioned earlier, Swamiji is not able to physically come over here and get connected to us in this Zoom meet. So I request Professor Murali Madhavan to read out his blessings. Professor Murali Madhavan. मुरली वादन जी मुरली वादन
sir sir what we can do is we can have yeah, we can. The lecture then we can have prediction later
now may I request professor Arindam Chakravarti ji University of Honolulu please kindly to deliver your first commemoration lecture on this topic which is very interesting Vedanta from Kerala to Kashmir comparing Shankara's and Abhinava Gupta's Advaita as Atman Brahman Parameshwara have the power to will the universe two different interpretations of ikshana in the Brahma Sutra Professor Arindam Chakravarti ji
after his speech I will read now it is yeah. clear
yes sir now. Fine
मातामह महाशैलम हेरंबम पपितामहम सीतारामं गुरुं नौमि द्वैताद्वैत विलक्षणं विश्वेन आरभ्य विश्रांता सर्वप्रहरणायुधे यस्य नामावलि तस्मै पद्मनाभाय वै नमः As we are holding this August meeting on the important inauguration of a 1000-year-old university, we have to remember that all of India is almost like the first sentence of the Prathamadhyaya Dvitiya Brahmana of Brihadaranyaka Upanishad with a little bit change of the tense, grammatical tense. One could say Mrityuna Eva Idam Avritamasti Idanim. And it is very sad. We should not joke about it. But Shankara told us something that everybody sings in Kerala. Prapte sannihite kalu marane nahi nahi rakshati mukhachhadane. Shankara didn't write Mukhachhadane. He wrote to Krinkarane. But since we are trying to protect ourselves by the masks, which is the only thing the government does not need to make available, we can all hold it. But I would seriously like all of us to silently pray, Sarve Santu Niramaya. I start because Murali Madhavanji told me that I must share some new Sanskrit verses that I have authored. Apart from my own comparison and some kind of synthesis between the Nirguna Brahmavada Kevaladvaita of Shankaracharya and the Shaktitraya Vishishtu Prakasha Vimarshamaya Pratyabhijna non-dualism Advaitavada of Abhinavagupta. But out of my Guru's grace, I found the greatest collaboration, the greatest endorsement of this meeting of the two in a text all of you know, but maybe it was definitely originating from Kashmir, but maybe the Patanapatana of that in Kerala needs to be revived. And that text is Yoga Vasishtha. And in Yoga Vasishtha, in a crucial chapter, Sri Ram, who is the student, as you know, the Bhagavad Gita intellectual atmosphere, the instructional relationship is reversed in the Yoga Vasishtha. In Bhagavad Gita, Narayana is the speaker, Nara is the hearer. In the Yoga Vasishtha, Nara, Vasishtha Rishi Muni, is the speaker and teacher, and Narayana is the student. That is Ramachandra. So Rama asks, and I'll come back to it after drawing the comparisons and contrasts. But Rama asks, you have described how Paramashiva, who is Nirguna Brahman, how he actually supports this world illusion, the dream that we call our life. But now tell me, how does Shankara's partner, Shakti, power, Kali, dance? Professor Radhakrishnan, am I audible? Okay, thank you. So, as far as I experienced it, just as on the one hand, you have Padmanabha Swami taking a long lying down rest by the seaside inside Kerala due to unnecessary division created by Western scholars between Agama and Nigama, neglected by Vedic pundits, but very much present in popular Keralian devoted mind, there is the dance of Bhadrakali. And partly I wanted to remind all of you that the Shankara is not only, of course, Western scholars will disagree, but we all know that in Kanchi, everywhere, in Shankaracharya Mathas, Shankara is a worshipper of Tripura Sundari, who is none other than Kali. There is a secret teaching of Kali in Kashmir. Abhinava Guptapad was an heir to that teaching, that is called Krama Tantrism. Krama. So Abhinava writes a long verse. The mool of it is lost, but there is Jayaratha's commentary available called Krama Stotra. And there he talks about Krama Tantrism is worshipping Kali in 12 successive forms. And I will not translate this, but this is my offering of synthesis of Agama and Nigama between Krama Kali. In fact, there is a beautiful poetry called Krama Keli in the Kashmir tradition, and the first verse of Ishopanishad. With all of your grace, after I retire, I have this sankalpa that I would try to write a Kashmir Shaiva Pratyabhijna Darshana Anuyayi commentary on the Isha Upanishad. All of you know that in the first verse, the word Jagat occurs, but also with a saptami locative case, Jagati also occurs. So I'm sure most of you will see where I am going with this. Here are my verses. Masadvadashameya Ritam cha satyam cha vidhattha vaso atyajayata tato ratyajayata tata samudro arnava samudrat arnavadati sangavatsaro ajayata koyam sangavatsaro Masadvadashameya Kali dvadasha rupini Chando rupa dhara sahi Jagati dvadashaksharam Jagati chanda dvadashakshara Matri mana pramebhyo Inna abhinna bibhairavat Ishavasyam jagat Tasyam jagatyam sthitam adbhutam. Dvadashaksharayam jagatyam dvadasharupinyam kalya idam jagat tishtati. Sarva bhava mayam chitram vichitram. Satyam satyanatyam idam jagat. Sarva bhavamayam chitram satya natyam idam jagat ardhanari swaras tatra nartaka sachit ambare athava tat jagat sat chidambare nartaka ardhanari swar. In a nutshell, there is a lot of overlap between Pratyabhijna Darshanam, Trika Darshanam, and Nirguna Brahma Darshanam, Kevala Advaita. There is only one difference. And in that difference, Yoga Vasishtha takes the side of Pratyabhijna and not the side of traditional. And with slight change, the shloka that all children memorize first, I will say it, the common view of both. Brahma Satyam, Jagat Satyam, Jivo Brahma Ivanapar. Sankshepena, this is what I want to talk about. The best place geographically to begin a study of the relation between Advaita in Kashmir and Advaita in Kerala is to begin in the eastern middle region between them, Bengal and Varanasi, where the greatest Bengali Advaitin lived in the 16th century. Madhusudana Saraswati was an uncompromising Advaitin. By his monumental work, Advaita Siddhi, he rescued Advaita Vedanta from the jaws of the devouring Nyayamrita, a vigorous Madhva dualist attack by Vyasatirtha. He also wrote against Nyaya Vaisheshika Shankara Mishra's Jewel of Difference, although he was a great Navya Nyayika, Madhusudana Saraswati. You see that when you see what logical, symbolic sophistication he does with double negation in the Mithyatva Mithyatva Prakaranam of Advaita Siddhi. Double negation does not yield the Pratyogi. But he refutes Shankara Mishra's Vedaratnam in a delightful book called Advaita Ratna Raksham. In all these texts, he defends the standard Advaita view that the Lord God that we worship and adore has the architect, or more accurately, the supreme dreamer of this universe is not the ultimately real pure consciousness. Medam yatitam upasate. Pure attributeless consciousness, which is unlimited by time, space, or individuality, can never be the object of any mental state, including the meditative state of upasana. Hence, that pure Brahman cannot be an object of worship. So the Ishwara that we can worship is Brahman consciousness as delimited by collective ignorance. Samashti Ajnana Upahita Chaitanya. Madhusudana Saraswati thus teaches, first, the official doctrine that infinite reality, all that there is, sarvam kaluidam, has no attributes, guna, no modes, relations, or qualities. Since words cannot relate to this ultimate infinite reality, you cannot speak of, let alone eulogize or chant the name of this highest and only reality, Nirguna Brahman. Yet, when is this his commentary on the Bhagavad Gita reaches the crucial 13th chapter, the yoga of distinction between the field and the field knower. I don't have time today. I will show you some examples of Abhinavagupta's poetry. But the prose of Shankara is as poetic and as humorous as any good prose can be. Okay. So in this context, those of you who are interested, in 13th chapter, Kshetra Kshetrajna Vibhaga Yoga, at one point, under the Kshetragam Kshetrajnam Chapi Mang Vidhi, under that verse, Shankara has the longest commentary, at the end of which, when he says, this Vyashti Shariratraya Avachinna Chaitanya Jeev is a result of avidya. So interlocutor asks, he himself makes up, like the language of Shavaraswami, like the language of Uddhavatakara. It is beautiful, colloquial, debate language, very friendly. But look at the beauty of the of Shankara's prose here. So he says, Nanu Kasya Yam Avidya. Remember, so Shankara is writing so many years, at least 500 to 600 years before Ramanuja. Okay. And all these ashraya anupapatti and all those, he anticipates. So he says, kasya yama vidya jaya upahitam chaitanyam jiva iti khyayate jaya vidya kasya yama vidya. So then Shankara discusses. And then at one point he asks the Purva Pakshin, that katam jayate jagat iti, and the Purupakshin says na jani na vidmo. Then Shankara says, now you know kasya vidya, yours, because he said naam janami, and it is not just a joke, because na kinchid abhedisham athava idam na janami, that is one of the proofs of avidya. But it's put in a dialogue. So at one point he says, I don't know, you tell me. And Shankara says, you don't know? So then my avidya must be yours. Ignorance is yours. But when Madhusudana comes to commenting on Trayodashadhyaya, Kshetra Kshetranjya Vibhagayo, suddenly, in no other chapter he does that, suddenly there is a new Mangala Shloka in Gita Gudartha Divika. And that is Dhyana Vyasa Vashi Kritena Manasa Tan Nirgunam Nishkriyam Jyoti Kinchana Yogino Yadiparam Pashyanti Pashyantute Asmakam Tu Lochana Chamatkaraya Bhuyachiram Kalindi Pulineshu Sayat Kimapitat Neelam Mahodhavati. If with mind is disciplined by the repeated practice of meditation, some yogins get to see that actionless, attributeless, formless light called Brahman. Let them see that. For us, bewitching our eyes, lochana chamatkaraya, let there always be whatever that is. That very blue light which runs around on the bank of Kalindi, the river Yamuna. Was Madhusudana deviating from strict Advaita? Is that even conceivable that Madhusudana will deviate from strict Advaita and showing his dualistic predilections? Scholars say that. Chaitanya's time. He's from Bengal, soft-headed person. He has still an attraction to Krishna. But you don't need to be Bengali to have an attraction to Krishna. Starting from Murali Madhavan, whose name is of Krishna's, all the way up to the recently passed away great physicist of India, George Sudarshan, who was a Christian. I once lived in his house in Austin, Texas. And in an evening party, where he took me. Suddenly I asked him, have you, I don't know whether they allow Christians to enter. You are a Christian. Have you ever visited Guruvayur temple? Just the name Guruvayur, I said. And George Sudarshan, the physicist, the Christian, he started shedding tears. I said, what happened? You have a problem with your eyes? He said, no. If you mention Guruvayur, I cannot stop crying. Okay. Was he not a rigorous, strict, good scientific physicist? Of course he was. Similarly, Madhusudana Saraswati was as strict an Advaitin as you can expect. Remember Advaita Siddhi. But he was not coming down from Akshara Brahma, from Nirguna Brahma. He was going above. Because the Bhagavad Gita says, Yasmat Ksharamati Toham Aksharadapi Chottama Atosmi Loke Vedecha Pratita Purushottama. And Abhinavagupta comes and says, you want to understand what Purushottama is? Study grammar. Purushottama is Uttama Purusha, the first person. And that is why, while Ahamkar is a vigna, obstacle, but in Aham Brahmasmi, Ahamiti, this is a sacred, most sacred, secret mantra. Why so? Because all of language, which is contained between a and ha, is contained in aham. A to ha. Shankara's philosophy is known as Shanta Brahmavad or Kevala Advaita. or sometimes as Maya Vedantavada. But it comes to a difficult point when Shankara has to fight Prakriti Karanavada or Pradhana Karanavada in 115, Brahma Sutra 115. What is that sutra? We all know. Ikshater na shabdam na ashabdam. Ikshater na. At this point, I am apologizing because I am entering into proper Vedanta, of which I am not an adhikari. Why? Sadhana chatushtaya shunyatvat. Okay? Adhikari tu vidivad adhita veda vedangatvena apatato adhikata akila vedartha asmin janmani purva janmani va sadhana chatushtaya sampanna pramada. None of these qualifications I have. But my Diksha Guru, who was a Ramanujai, he used to say, seeing that Advaita Vedanta is so popular in all over the world, he used to say, in some Purana, Bhavishya Purana or something, there is a statement, Kalau Vedantina Sarve Phalgune Valakaiva. Little children sing erotic love songs without understanding when in the month of Phalgun. So like Phalgune Valakaiva, I will do a little bit of Brahma Sutra Vyakhyana. Sankhya parikalpitam achetanam pradhanam jagatak karanam na shakyam vedanteshu ashrayitu. We cannot accept that pradhana or prakriti is the jagat karan. In Sankhya philosophy, there is an ultimate difficulty. And the difficulty is that Purusha, even if you think of Seshwara Sankhya, even Purusha Vishesha, cannot participate in causality. Karya Karana Bhava Madhye Parina Pariname Karya Karana Sambandhe Purushasya Kopi Sambandho Nasti. In fact, you can be briefer. Purushasya Kenapi Sa Kopi Sambandho Nasti. Purusha is Asambandha. Asambandha. It is Prakriti Trigunatmika. And this Prakriti is avidya in Advaita Vedanta. But Prakriti is not the Karana of the world. Why? Because Shruti, Shabda, says, Tadaikshata bahusyam prajaya. From the very start, from the very get-go, you have a difficulty there in the Upanishads. It is not a difficulty. Upanishad story is very simple, straightforward, and deep. And that is what is picked up by Abhinava Gupta directly. But by the time you come to Gaudapada Shankara, this is a Iksham Chakre Prashna Upanishad. This Iksha, where is it coming from? It is coming from Ekaki Sabai Naivareme. Come on. Purna Brahma Nareme is Sachidananda. How can he be Nareme? Perfect explanation in Kashmir Shaivism. Why? Because Paramashiva is not Nishkriya, Swatantrena Sakri, Ichha Shaktima. And one of those things that he wants to do, I will not have time to explain this, but Shiva has five duties. Like all of us modern people, I'm sure Murali Madhavanji also, because as you grow old, you forget what you have to do. We put a list of to do on the fridge. At least we do that here in America. Ki this idam kartavyam agamini dine. So Shiva has panchakritya. Kritya panchakam. Srishti, sthiti, pralaya of the universe. These three plus very important. Although Shiva is antakasya antaka. That's why my decision is, if you see that the world is not ekam, the jagat is vichitra, vishwa vichitra chitrasya, alekhyakara, is Shiva. He is a free, swatantra, chitrakara. But you have to see the world as nana eva. We can write a whole dissertation thesis on the meaning of that eva. But one who sees the world as nana eva, he attains Maheshwara. That is why Isha Upanishad says, not as a threatening to the Bahubadi, but as a blessing. Mrityo sa mrityum apnoti yaya nana iva pashyati. Koyam mrityo mrityu antakasyapi antaka Maheshwara swayam. Okay? This is a common formulation in Ishukena Upanishad and in Srimad Bhagavatam. Okay? Shrotrasya shrotram manaso mano yat vachoha vacham sahu pranasya prana chakshushash chakshur atimuchya dhira pratyasman loka amrita bhavanti. And why Srimad Bhagavatam in Rasa Mandala? After disappearing, this is another job that Shiva has, and so does Krishna, which is to disappear. Tirobhav. So panchakritya madhye, srishti, sthiti, laya, tirobhav and anugrah. These are the five. Now this tirobhav, after nimesha, there is unmesha. There is here, then appears in the rasa mandala, after the Gopi Gita. After they cry, Jayati te dikam janamana braja shrayata indira shashvadatre truti yugayate tvama atasi yad bhavanan hikananam truti yugayate tvama pashyatam daita drishyatam vikshutavaka stvaidita savastvam vichinnate. After they are crying, he comes back and in one short verse, Vyasa says in Srimad Bhagavatam, how does he come back? Tasam avira vichauri smayamana mukambuja sakshat manmatha manmatha ane anayaritya mrityo mrityu namaka maheshwaraya mrityo samrityu maapnoti yaya nanayava pashyati. Okay, so these are the five jobs of Shiva. And one of them is Iksha. Because when he covers himself and he appears, Sarvajna appears to be Alpajna. He knows everything, he's omniscient. But he appears to be Kinchidri, knows a little bit, doesn't know. He's Nitya Jnanavan, Swabhaviki Jnana Valakriyaj. But he appears not only to others. There is no other at that point. Ekaki. But he appears as if I don't have any companion. Tada ikshata bahusyam srijaya. Okay. So, Shankara says, this kriya सर्वज्ञ ईश्वर कारण पराणि वाक्यानि यत्तु उक्तम. इफ somebody says why can't prakriti do the iksha, pradhan can do the iksha. Shankara says no, pradhana is jada, he cannot do the iksha. Then the interlocutor Purupakshin says, Sankhya says, come on, what is iksha? Jnana janya bhaved iksha. So iksha is basically a kind of jnana, and jnana is the function not of purusha, not of brahman, but of buddhi. So sattva pradhana prakriti, when sattva gunasya udreko bhavati, when sattva guna is pradhan, then buddhi acts. At this point, in extremely contemporary 21st century cognitive science and philosophy of mind and theory of consciousness, a major distinction is made between two kinds of consciousness. One kind of consciousness always has an object. It is consciousness of a cup, consciousness of a table. This in Advaita Vedanta is called vritti jnana, savishayaka. It has objects. In fact, in the beginning of European phenomenology, Franz Brentano said the defining characteristic, the vyavartaka dharma of consciousness as against jada, achetana, chetana, chaitanya, is savishayaka, whereas jada has no vishaya. This is one kind of consciousness. But more recently, another kind of consciousness is talked about. That is pure subjectivity, which has no object. And this is called phenomenal awareness, consciousness. What it is like to be something. More internally to be felt. Internally, not in the sense of antarindriya. But this is indriyatita consciousness, which has no vishaya. This is closest to this, is the concept of swaprakasha or sakshi chaitanya in Advaita Vedanta. Okay? Avedyatve sati aparoksha vyavahara yogyatva. These two types of consciousness have been distinguished. So jnanam vishaya, savishayakam jnanam, ghata jnanam, pata jnanam, knowledge of this, knowledge of that. This is actually a property of buddhi. And if God made a sankalpa, bahusyam prajaya, where is this bahu? It is in the future. Sankalpa vishaya anagate tishtati. Shvaha idam karishyami. Tat karyam, that object is not yet here, but buddhi can make it an object. So, nana uktam, sarva jnana shakti matvena prakriti reva sarvajmo bhavet. Let prakriti be sarvajmo. But now we are coming to the weakest point of Advaita, of Sankhya philosophy. And Sankhya philosophy is so strong as our past. Okay? And this is characteristic of India's material culture as well as intellectual culture. We have got hybrid electric cars on the street, but we have not given up the bullock cart. The bullock cart is still there. We don't throw away either our old computers or our old parents on the street. We keep them. And Pitri Paitama, we remember them in the Pitripaksha with Tarpana. Okay? Pita, Pitamaha, Matamaha, Pitamaha, Vidha Prapitamaha, all of them. Similarly, Sankhya is the earliest darshan of India. Mahabharata's philosophy is Sankhya philosophy. But Sankhya is refuted as pradhanamallo, Pradhanamalla Nirvana Nyayena. Sankhya is refuted. But this is not science. You have refuted, now you throw away Sankhya. Sankhya is revived again. All the 25 tattvas of Sankhya are revived by Utpala Deva, by Shiva Drishti, by Somananda. And adding to that, 11 more tattvas, you get Shatrinshat tattva. Sankhya is fully preserved in the Shivadvaita, Paramadvaita of Pratyabhija. Sankhya is not rejected. But Sankhya has a weak point. And Jayantavatta in Nyayamanjari, after a long criticism, rejection of Prakriti Karanavad, he, again Jayantavatta from Kashmir, he summarizes beautifully. Srinivasji, are you still there? I don't know.
Yes. Yeah, I'm here.
Nyayamanjari, he says, summarizes in one sentence the rejection of Sankhya. What? The rejection is Chiddharmascha Mrisha Buddhau Buddhi Pratibimbitam Purusha Purushasya Dharma Chetana. But Vastutaha Buddhau Chetana Nasti. There is no Chetana in a material, a brain type, material Buddhi. There are neurons, but neuron does not have Chetana. Chiddharmascha Mrisha Buddhau. Buddhi Dharma, and Buddhi's Dharma is Vritti. Vishaya, Vishaya Mimukattu. Vishayavi, Vishaya Sapekshattu. Vishaya, Vishaya Mukhinattu. This Buddhi Dharma, Mrisha Chiti, it is only falsely superimposed on Chit. Chit does not have intentional consciousness. And pure phenomenal consciousness is not there in Buddhi. But it is by the cooperation of the two that any cognition is possible. So, for Jayanta, this is an enough khandan. Comes on stage, tata pravishati advaita vedante, in the natya. He says, I will make an ishtapatti of this. Yes, all our cognitions of objects is based on satyanrite mituni kriti. Okay. But it is not so easy to explain the iksha. Okay. So Shankara, he says, because the Purupakshin says, how can your Brahman also do iksha? Okay. My Pradhana Prakriti is Jada. So she cannot do iksha. So how does your Brahman do iksha? Brahman is also Nishkriya, Niricha. So Shankara says, Sakshi Nimittam Ikshitrattam. Sakshi Chaitanya Nimittam Brahman. Ishwara, Brahmana, Brahmana, Ikshitrita. So then Purupakshin says, okay, we have Sakshi Purusha. So Sakshi Nimittam, Pradhanasyabi Ikshitritvam. Pradhan, let Pradhana be the Ikshana Kartri. Okay, let Pradhana do the cosmic resolution, we will now be many. The plurality is desired. Let that desire come from there. Shankara says, Atra Uchyate, Idam Tavat Bhavan Prashtavya. Because the Sankhya Purupakshin was saying, look, and it reminds me of the Nayayika's liberated soul. As all of you know, the liberated self of Nayayika do not have any jnana. Because jnanam is savishayakam and you depend on another object, then sarvam paravasham dukkham. Therefore, dukkhatyanta bhav papavarge jnanam nasti. There is no cognition. So nayayika mukti is like pashana sadrish. There is no jnanam. Sankhya says, your nirguna brahman is also like that. It does not have any vishayata sambandha with anything. So how can it be sarvajna? In fact, our pradhana can be sarvajna. When it is sattva pradhana, then mahat knows everything. Because mahat is pure, sattva pradhana. Yes, a little bit of rajas is there. That is why it has the vritti. It can vishayam pratidhavati. Kene shitam patati preshitam mana. Kena prana pratama praiti yukta. So there is a gati in the pranadi, and prakriti itself can be served. And Shankara says, how can you say that my Brahman is not sarvajna? Sarva vishaya abhasana kshamam jnanam nityam asti. Sarva vishaya kam jnanam asmin brahmani nityam asti. Apicha nasau sarvajna iti tu viprasit pratishiddham iti tu vatato vyagat. How can you call it? Now our question will be, now, which Brahman is he talking about? He's talking about Saguna Brahman. Because Nirguna Brahman does not have Sarvajnatva. But Shankara has Pratibha. In the Mundaka Shruti, Yas Sarvajna Sarvavit, Yasya Jnanamayam Tapa. Shankara, Sarvam Janati Iti Sarvajna, interprets it that way. But then he gives an interpretation. I don't know how many of you have seen that. It shows that he is talking by sarvajna adjective. He is talking about Shuddha Brahma, Nirguna Brahma. Why? Because he says, Natu sarvam janati ti sarvajna, but sarvashchaso jnascha. I am Atma Brahma Sarva. Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma. Apicha Jnaswarupa. Sarvaschaso Jnascha. Sarvajam. Okay? Not a Dvitiya Tatpurusha Samas or Upapada Tatpurusha Samas, but it is a Karmadara Samas. Sarvaschaso Jnascha. But with all that technique, till the end, we don't have time here to study all of this. I will now come to how is Abhinav Gupta's interpretation would be. We don't have Abhinav Gupta's direct interpretation of Ikshanam, but here and there in Vibhriti Vimarshini, the longer book, Ishwara Pratyagna Vimarshini, everybody reads. And another curious fact, Murali Madhavanji, my dear friend and the world's greatest Kashmir Shaiva scholar in Rome University, La Sapienza, called Raffaele Torella, found one small lost fragment of Utpaladeva's Vivriti and Abhinava's Vivriti Vimarshini, the longest book. You know where? Not in Lucknow, not in Srinagar, not in Delhi archive. There are some in National Archive. But in Grantha script, in Thiruvananthapuram Oriental Institute Manuscript Library. Okay? So we should be both proud and ashamed that somebody from Rome knows about it. We should be ashamed. And we should be proud that it exists in Thiruvananthapuram. There's nothing wrong in having these parasparo opposite sentiments of pride and shame.
Correct.
In Valmiki Ramayanam, when Bharata came,
yes,
take him back. And Ram didn't go. So all the Ayodhya Vasins, with Bharata going away, crying, but they're also very happy. Valmiki says, nobody is more contemporary a poet than Valmiki. Like good. A modern poet, he says.
Good.
Tamadbhutam dairyam aveksha ragave. Samam jano harsham abab dukkhita. Dukkhito bhutva harsham abab. Katam. Nayatya yodhyam iti dukkhito bhavat. Sthira pratijmattvam aveksha harshita. So we can be lajjita and also, you know, sadarpa, both. So to come back to Abhinavagupta. Abhinavagupta says in Vibhriti Vimarshini, at the end of it, and he is somebody who is as sharp in argumentation and as imaginative in poetry as he is in open description of his own spiritual experience. And after writing his big book, Vibhriti Vimarshini. Okay. He ends the book by telling people, why are you wasting time reading my book? I have only roamed around that real thing. But Sangvit Dhamani Shambhave Vishatha Chet Kaliyam Ekam Lavam. For 1 second, if you enter into your own Sangvit Dhamma, the inner citadel, go to Chidambaram. The innermost is an empty room. Akasha Murti of Shiva. Sangvit Dhamani Shambhave Vishatha Chet Kaliyam Ekam Lavam. Kim kim varnanika abhirabhuta abhita. What is the point of my varnanika? This whole book is calling varnanika. These little descriptions that I am giving. Kim kim varnanika abhirabhirabhita satyam swayam jnasyata. He is telling his readers. So that Abhinavagupta summarizes briefly. Shakti Sanchaya Shivasya Brahmana Bhava Bhavya Shaktaya Santi Bhavya Shaktaya Santi Ichha Shakti Jnana Shakti Kriya Shakti Smriti Shakti Abohana Shakti Jnana Shakti. You will say, oh, this is all tantric stuff. Then you'll have to say Bhagavad Gita is tantric, coming from the tribals, because Bhagavad Gita says, Matta Smritir Jnanam Apohanancha. And that is how Ishvara Pratyavidami Varshini, Jnanadhikar, is fourth chapter, Smriti Pariksha. Smritir Jnanam Apohanancha. Fifth chapter, Jnana Pariksha. Sixth chapter, Apohana Pariksha. Vicheda Shakti. Distinguishing the power of excluding. Ago Vyavritti is the essence of Gotva. This is a Buddhist doctrine. But Gita says, Apohana. Matta Smriti Jnanam Apohanancha. Okay. So he says, Shakti Sanchaya Gananam Ashakyam Iti Darshayan Etadaha Asmad Darshan. That is, this Kriya Ichchadi Yukta Sakriya Brahmavada Anabhyupagame. If you do not accept our theory of a vibrant, active Brahman as paramarthika, not vyavaharika, paramarthika. Asmat darshana anabhyupagame brahma vivartavado jada vivartavada eva. Katam jadyam nam swatantrasya bhava. If you do not have freedom, then you are jada. What is freedom? Kartum akartum anyata kartum vashakti. Tasmat swatantra karta. Tat swatantram shivasya. Shiva has paramarthika. Ultimate reality in Shiva has free will. In that free will, he is a kavi. He is a poet. And he makes and remakes the world. Okay? He will make a country. In one point, Vishwaguru. And in the next moment, he makes that country the worst in the whole world. He makes something the best, the strongest, and the richest. And the next, he makes it the poorest developing country. He makes medical science progress, advance so much that people don't die till they're 100 years old, no disease, all vaccines. And then suddenly, he kills everybody. This is his Vaichitra Rachana. And this is not Vyavaharika, not of only Samashti Agyana Upahita Chaitanya. This is coming from Shiva, who is both Karta Bhokta Maheshwara. Okay. So this is the theory. Asmat Darshana Anabhyupagame Brahma Vivartavado Jada Vivartavade Tatracha Avidya Api Vivarta Tattu Papadika Na Samarthaitum Shakya Iti Vitanitam Shivadrishto. Somananda Shivadrishti has explained it elaborately. Okay. So now I have only two jobs left. I will list 9 distinctions between Advaita Brahmavad, this Shankara's Advaita, and Abhinavagupta's Advaita. And I told you about Brahma Satyam, there is no other Satya than Shiva. And that Shiva is Aham, Jivo Brahmaivanava. I have to recognize myself. Advaita Vedanta, you have only Dashamastumasi. Here you have elaborate theory of recognizing yourself in the darpan, and very nice poetic theory of self-recognition. Okay, you have forgotten who you are. And Yoga Vashishtha has many, many stories to interpret that. Okay. But I had also said, I will show you the Yoga Vashishtha Praman. Because unfortunately, the late 16th century commentary that we get in Yoga Vashishtha, Sanskrit commentary, that is more advertised all over North India, is an Advaita, Shankara Advaita commentary. But there is another commentary that they have discovered in Germany by Bhaskara Kantho, who wrote Bhaskari commentary on Ishvara Pratyabhijna Vimarshini. That 3-volume K.C. Pandey edition has Bhaskari in it. And that same Bhaskara Kantha wrote a commentary on the Mool text, of which Yoga Vashishtha is a vulgate. It is a mixture of other texts. Real text was called Mokshopaya. And Mokshopaya is a Bhaskara Kantha Tika. And in Mokshopaya, Rama asks, after understanding the Advaita Tattva, in the absolute pure form, he says, Anantaram Mune Vashishtha, he is addressing Vashishtha. Now, after this Mune, O sage, Bruhi Kali Kimiva Nrityati. Why and how does Kali dance? And Yoga Vashishtha remembers Keno Upanishad. He remembers this mantric name, ఉమా సతస్మిన్ ఆకాశే స్త్రియమాజగామ ఉమాం హైమవతిం బహుశోభమాన. ఓకే, నౌ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యు అద్వైతిన్స్ వుడ్ సే ఓ దట్ ఇస్ ది అవిద్య, బట్ ట్రై సేయింగ్ దట్ టు అభినవ గుప్త దట్ ఉమా ఇస్ అవిద్య. నౌ ఉమా ఇస్ ది అర్ధనారీశ్వర హాఫ్ చాంపేయ గౌరార్ధ శరీర కాయ. Okay, half. That is Uma. So she says, Omkara Sara Shaktitvat Umeti Parikritita. Om has four matras. A matra, U matra, Ma matra, and Ardha matra. This Ardha matra cannot be pronounced. So Durga Saptashati says, अर्धमात्रा स्थिता नित्या या अनुच्चार्या. सो ओंकार सार शक्तित्वात् उमे उमेति परिकीर्तिता, उमा इति परिकीर्तिता गायत्री गायनात्मत्तात् सावित्री प्रसवस्थिते, सा एव गायत्री. बट राम इज अ गुड स्टूडेंट एंड वेरी इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द फ्यूचर शंकराचार्य. So Rama says, wait a minute. Sri Rama Uvacha, Chite Kalpaha Sharirinya. This Kali is Sharirini. This Uma is Sharirini. Bahushobamana. Sargo ye ange sitasitastatha. Tasya ange bhuvanatrayam. Saptavyaritaya. Sarvam omkaratagata. Ombu, omhuva, omaswa, omama, omjana. Om tapa, om satyam, om tat savitur varenyam gayatri. Bhargo devasya dhimahi dhiyo yona prachodayat. Apo jyotiraso mritam brahma bhurvasvaram. Those of you who are interested in sahitya, see how in the deepest upasana paddhati of Vedikas, the word rasa occurs. Even before Taittiriya Upanishad, raso vaisa. It occurs. Apo jyoti raso amritam brahma bhurbhuvasvaram. And it is a mistake to think that here rasa means physical water or juice. Here means saeva rasanam rasatama. That Upanishadic rasa. And this rasa, says, omkara sara rupatvat. So Rama is asking, Chite kalpa sharirinya ye ange sthita bhuvanadaya te kim atmani tishthanti. Atmani, purna brahmani, shuddha brahmani, kim te tishthanti uta asatya satyava. Are these worlds, this nanamaya, these vaichitramaya worlds, these all different shaktis, do they exist in Atman Paramarthata? And Yoga Vashishtha says, anequivocally. Okay, as we say in Bengali, dvyarthahina bhasha. There is no two meanings, only one meaning. And it says, Rama, say Vashishtha uvacha, Rama, asau kila chit shakti, asau kila chit shakti, staya yachya uditam tatha tat chetitam. Chetitam, it is abhasitam. Atayev satyam iti akhilam. Yat, to exist, is to be perceived. If it is perceived, if it is felt, it is experienced, then it exists, it is real. And then he repeats, if you say it is in Vishwam Darpana, Darpana Dishyamanam, it is in a mirror, Drishtva Nijantargata, then I will say Adarsheshu, that means in mirror, Adarsheshu, Athava Swapne, dream, Sarga संकल्पने अस्तु वा बहुस्यां प्रजाया इति संकल्प श्वाइदं करिष्यामि देयर विल बी अ रिवाइवल ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्सिटी इट इज नॉट येट रिवाइव्ड बट यू हैव संकल्प इज इट नॉट सत्य इट्स नॉट सत्य नाउ इट विल बी सत्य इन द नेक्स्ट फ्यू इयर्स यू हैव टेकन अ 5-year प्रोजेक्ट 10-year प्रोजेक्ट That project is sankalp. Adarsheshu athava swapne sarga sankalpane stuva sa atmani arthakaritvat. Arthakaritvat satya itteva memati. Katam satyam arthakaritvat. Then even Yoga Vasishtha, although it is a kavya, in our kavyas you can have good argumentation. Next. Mama Narthaya, sir. But it does not do any work for me. Mirror image does not do. In my dream, if I get the Nobel Prize, that does not come to any use. Because Mama na artha kriyakari. Mama Narthaya, sir. Iti chet. If you say, this is not real for me because it does not work. If it is just dream, it does not work. It is avidya. So it is not paramartha. Then he is counter-arguing. Iti chet katam bhave deshantargata sarve bhavantu arthaya sampratya. Okay. In deshantara, in Hawaii, all of us have got both the vaccines. Is it of any use to you? No. People who are dying in Isn't that real? Well, it is real, although it is of no use to me. Because it's deshantaragata. If deshantaragata vastu can be satya without being arthakriyakari for me, then swapna vastu also can be arthakriyakari for swapnastha. Okay? In the dream, the characters, they are getting some work done by that. So this is the argumentation which goes on. 9 points of distinction. I'm sorry I'm going on for a long time, but I have only taken 40 minutes up till now. Okay? Because the preliminary, I looked at the watch, was almost 50 minutes, 50. So, you have to let me just summarize these 9 points. Chit or Brahman in Shankara's Advaita is only Prakasha Swarup, Chinmatra Swarup, Jnana. Although this Jnana is Swaprakasha, but it does not have any conceptual structure. The moment conceptual structure comes, idam ittham iti, that becomes vikalpa, judgment. So this is nirvikalpaka jnanam prakashamatram. Chit, that is pure consciousness in Kashmir Shaivism is both prakasha and vimarsha. That is why Ardhanarishwara holds a mirror with the female part to himself. So every cognition as a distinct phenomenon also looks back at itself. And this is different from the Advaita Vedanta Swaprakash. And this Vimarsha Shakti is also the root of creativity. New things are created. Navanavonmesha comes from this Vimarsha Shakti. And this Navatva is not Pratibhasika. Not vyavaharika, paramarthika. First distinction. Prakasha only in Shankara Advaita, Prakasha Vimarsha in Kashmir Advaita. Second, Kriya, activity, belongs only to Maya and Avidya in Shankara. That's why Naishkarma Siddhi. Okay. But in Kashmir Advaita, the Advaita Tattva Shiva Shakti Samanvaya, Paramashiva, has Swatantra and Kriya Shakti. Third, so I feel like saying that Kashmir is a cold place. People can really work hard. And the Kashmiri Brahman is always busy. Spandaman, Spandakarika is a text also. He's vibrating consciously. Create more and more avishrantam, trailokyam kalpana shatai. With hundreds of new kalpanas, he's creating many, many worlds. All the time. But you come to Kerala, it's a beach enjoying tourist who just sleeps. He's on the beach, nishkriya, writes books like Naishkarmya Siddhi. So this is the distinction between the two Brahmans. Third, Maya is anirvachaniya, indefinable. So the Khyativad theory of error is that error is inexplicable as neither real nor unreal. But the Khyativad in Kashmir Advaita, also it is Advaita. So it also agrees that you are making a mistake when you think that there are many realities that I am different from Brahman. That's a mistake. But a mistake is not anirvachaniya. It is apurna khyati. So the theory is called apurna khyati. And when you say, but what do you say about Rajju Sarpa? Abhinav Gupta says, not only is Rajjo Sarpa Darshanam, Shukto Rajato Darshanam, is seeing silver in a seashell, not only is that a mistake, seeing the seashell as seashell, that is also a mistake. That is also apurna, even according to Advaita Vedanta. Because the seashell is actually Chaitanya. So it is more or less purna. It is very apurna if you see it as a snake. If you see it as a rope, it is purnatara, but it is still apurna. So all our judgmental cognitions, avikalpaka jnanam, all of them are apurna khyati. But purna purnatara, apurnatara, there is that tiftaratamya. Fourth distinction, in the case of empirical ego or jiva, the Atman is inactive and all activity belongs to buddhi. And Shankara here is indebted to, he basically takes the Sankhya view of this mithyasam yoga between buddhi, vritti, sattva, guna, and the nirguna sakshi. But that is not what Abhinava's theory of a jiva is. Abhinava's theory is of different coats. Like Murali Madhavanji is wearing a waistcoat and then a shirt and then an undershirt. Okay, in cold countries, Paramashiva, Kashmir, wears five kanchukas, pancha kanchuka theory. Okay. Now, fifth distinction, the universe is mithya or unreal. I've already said in the beginning, with the evidence of Yoga Vashishta, Jagat Satyam. Okay, just as Swapna is Satyam, Adarsha Pratibimba is Satyam, Jat Chetyate Tat Satyam. Whatever is abhasate, whatever appears, whatever is experienced, not as an object, but the experience itself, it must be satyam. In mukti, liberation, the universe is annulled. There is no ajativada, and there is no, for the videha mukta person, there is no world. Okay, and this is why Madhvas think that the videha mukta person of Advaita Vedanta is almost a shunyavadi. I don't think that is a fair criticism, but it looks like that because it is, the world is annulled. There is no world. In liberation, the universe appears as a form of Shiva consciousness and you enjoy, the Jivan Mukta enjoys the Nanatva. And after Mukti, he sees Vishwam Darpana Drishyamana Nagarim Drishtva Nijantar Katam. Okay, यक्षाक्षात् कुरुते प्रबोध समये आफ्टर प्रबोध यू सी द विश्व इन निजांतर्गतम् ओके विश्वात्म सो दिस इज आई वुड से दक्षिणामूर्ति स्तोत्र इज मोर लाइक कश्मीर शैवism सिक्स्थ टिफ सेवेंथ टिफ डिस्टिंक्शन अकॉर्डिंग टू शंकर वेदांत अविद्या इज रिमूव्ड बाय विद्या एंड व्हेन दिस हैपेंस देयर इज मुक्ति और लिबरेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू नॉन डुअलिस्टिक शैव फिलॉसफी अद्वैत प्रत्यभिज्ञाद्वैतवाद देयर आर टू काइंड्स ऑफ अज्ञान देयर इज पौरुष अज्ञान एंड देयर इज बौद्ध अज्ञान आवर शास्त्रिक नॉलेज अखंडार्थ ज्ञान दिस कैन रिमूव द पौरुष अज्ञान ओके थियोरेटिकली वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड बट फॉर रियल मिस्टिकल एक्सपीरियंस टू हैपन फॉर रियल मिस्टिकल एक्सपीरियंस टू हैपन वी हैव टू have the grace of Shiva, Anugrah. Without the grace of Guru, Shiva, there is no direct experience of this Pratyabhijna. You can recognize yourself to be Shiva himself. Okay, only by the grace. I was listening carefully. The gentleman who is the architect of this future project, he said that one of the first things that you will start in your new university is a discussion of Kaushitaki Brahman. Now, Kaushitaki Upanishad has a very interesting support for this Pratyabhijna philosophy because it says that after a perfect sadhaka, a spiritual aspirant, after death, through Devajana, Archiradi Margen, Gacchati, and then finally, there is a Purusha, a sort of mysterious person, Purushottama, sitting on a Brahmakatta, on a bed. This is in Kaushitaki Upanishad. And he asks, before admitting the departed soul, he asks, Kastvam, who are you? And the liberated person answers, Aham Tvamev, I am you. And then he says, welcome, come here. And he is welcome. You can check in Kaushitaki Upanishad. Okay, so this is the seventh distinction, that liberation is of a different kind. Eighth distinction is that this Upasana, I started by saying, who was Madhusudana Saraswati worshipping? Okay. Nirguna Brahmana Upasana Nasti. Saguna Brahmana Eva Upasana. But then who are you worshipping? And Abhinav Gupta's theory, Utpala's theory, Somananda's theory, is that this same Shiva Shakti, who is the Paramartha Sat, is also Pujya Upasya. So, and this Upasana takes the form, Abhinav Gupta here quotes the Bhagavad Gita, that famous verse with which I think many Brahmins from north to south start eating, okay, apart from Pranayaswa, Panayaswa. And that mantra is Brahmarpam Brahmavir, Brahmagnam Brahmana. And as Abhinav Gupta in his Gita commentary, okay, as Abhinav Gupta comments on this, he explains this verse. He says, Yatha Mayiva Uktam, by a verse about Goddess. Under this verse, Brahma Arpanam Brahma Abhi, even the Hota is Brahma. You can ask in the Vishnu Sahasranam, what kind of man? Brahman is like a prime minister. He likes to be praised. He likes his praises. That doesn't sound nice. Why stuti priya? Stabhya stava priya stota. Stuti stota arana priya. But then you don't notice, he is not only Stava Priya. Whose Stava? His own Stava. By himself, Stata Stota is also him. So Brahmarpanam Brahmavi, Brahmagno Brahmanavatam, Brahmayvatena Vantavi. Under this, now notice, okay, the beauty of Avinava's verse. Here he quotes, Tava chaka kila na stutirambike. Tava chaka kila na stutirambike. Akila shabdamai khalpetam. Nikila murti shume bhavadanvaya. Manasi jasu bahi prasarasucha. Akila shabdamai. Akila shabdamai tavatanu. Yat yat shabdam varnam uchcharayam. That sir, whatever I pronounce, whatever I utter, that is your stuti. Tavacha ka kila nastutiram vike. Akila shabdamai kila tetan. Nikila shabdamai kila tetan. Akila murti shume bhavadanmaya. Manasi jasu bahi prasadasucha. Iti vichintya shive shamita shive. Jagati jatam ayatna vashaditam. Stuti japarchana chintana varjita nakalu kachana kala kalastime. There is not a fraction of a second in my life which is without your stuti, without your chintana, without your archana. This is whose archana? This Uma Haimavati Yukta, that Shiva, that Brahman. Chakshushas chakshurati mucchadhira srotrasya srotra mrityo mrityo. That Brahman, that Paramapurushottam, is the object with whom I am identical. But I recognize that. Okay. And so with these eight distinctions, I don't have time to talk about. I'll now share screen and show you at the end of Vibhrati Bhimarshini, Abhinava Gupta puts this point of his Advaita by a comparison with looking at as if Shiva is in front of you. Okay? Shiva is in front of you. You look at his eyes from which Anugraha is, you know, being showered. Okay? Like Nrisimhadeva's eyes oozed with love for Prahlad. Prapanna chichido nakha. Right? Shiva's eyes, two eyes, these two eyes, he's first looking at. And he has to be seen by both of them. So here he adopts Dvaita Drishti. But as Shiva's grace comes, the bhakta gets focused in the middle between the two eyes, in the bindu. And in that, he sees only one eye, Advaita Drishti. That's the tritiyam. Tritiya shabdasya ganite a dvitiya iti artha. Not tritiyam. Tritiyam. So, look at this now. Is my screen visible, Murali Madhavanji? Yes or no? Yes?
Yes.
Oh, okay, thank you. Okay, I'm coming to that. This is the last. Brahmadi kitantam anantakam yat lokatraye vedaka chakravalam tad dvaita drishtyaiva swavarnamittam tadiya chakshur yugalam vyanakti. When I look at the horizon, chakravalam, the horizon of the world, of the three worlds, lokatray, three worlds, the horizon of all the perceivers, every perceiver, Atrinam, Vedakanam, Chakravalam, those who know things, Vedaka, Vedanakarta, Vedaka, Tesham Chakravalam, Te Kidrisha, all the way up to Krimi, a worm, an insect, Keet, Brahmadi Keetantam, Anantakam Jat, Lokatray, Vedaka Chakravalam, Tad dvaita trishtya eva. That I see with a duality, two eyes. Swavarnam, of its own kind. Like the Vedaka Chakravala, the eyes are also in the world of duality. Tadiya chakshur yugalam yanakti. Your kind, karunya purn, sadaya chakshur yugmu, yugalam. Tat vyanakti, this world of duality, subject, object, I, another, yusmat asmat pratyaya, this yugala is like your chakshu yugala. Ittham vimirsha, deeply contemplating and debating within my mind, ittham, in this way, vimirsha, aham ananta shaktim. Vishranta dhir dvaita drisham, this dvaita drishti has ananta shakti. This dvaita drishti has the power to create two by two. Go, ago, ashwa, anashwa, manushya, amanushya, gata, agata, pata, apata. Like this, it can create ananta things. Vishranta dhir dvaita drisham jihasu. Now I want to give up. I want to give up. Nityakshu, I want to jihasu. Okay, I want to give up this duality. Tvad bhakti sandarshita shuddha marga. Tvad bhakti sandarshita shuddha marga. Nirargali bhavita bhuri bhava. The windows of my heart have opened. Nirargali bhuta. The argalas have opened. Tvad bhakti sandarshita shuddha marga. Now I've got the pure path. Samam. Samaprodhgata vedanakhya bindustha, in the point, middle point. Netrantara shobamanam. So, Varkheriji, it is not only the Madhyamika Buddhist who is Madhyastha. Vijnana Bhairava has a secret method of meditation. He says, Graya Grahaka Sambitti Sarvatra Samana Sarvesha Yoginam to Visheshoyam Sambande Savadanata Natu Amanna Mamannaviti Natu Amannada Amannadaiti Parantu Bindu Madhye Aham Shloka Krit Aham Shloka Krit Aham shloka krediti, tritiyam netra. Jat, prameyam, pramatrinasa, eki karoti, uvayam eki karoti. Samot, samagrodgata vedanakhya, bindustha netrantara shobamanam, bhavantam antakrita vishvarupam, advaita drishtim, shiva sangshritosmi. Thank you.
Namaskar. Professor Chakravarti ji, adiva samichi namasit. But just samaya bhavat bahu vyakhyanam kartum avasaro nalabdha.
Nalabdha.
Samichi.
And you told me to speak in English. So yeah. That takes time. You have to explain.
Yo, there are several among audience, several people, they are lovers of Sanskrit. They know philosophy, but they cannot follow fully in Sanskrit if it is.
Right.
That is the difficulty. So that's why I requested you to have both languages.
I hope the mixture
will you are a Samyasaji. So Sanskrit and English, you can use both. That is why. Okay, Professor Radhakrishnan.
Yes. It was a very, very enthralling lecture. In fact, we say yata bijat bhavet vrikshaha vrikshat bijam. A tree evolves out of a bija, and the bija is a tree which is involved in it.
Right.
Within this 1 hour of lecture of Professor Arindam Chakrabarti ji, he has involved into this a plethora of Ramana texts. How many texts he has quoted from? It is a real marvel, sir. We are so fortunate to listen to you. But personally, I feel so enthralled that such a great professor of your eminence has really put in nutshell such a wonderful philosophy, particularly the comparison of Shankara's Advaita and Abhinav Gupta's Advaita. And what an amount of comparison you have started your lecture with, like the Gita and the Yoga Vasishta, the Narayana concept, who is addressing and who is the listener, and about the Masa Dwadashi and the Dwadashakali. And very wonderfully you put out this Satyajita Ambara in the Ardha Narishra form, and by spitting the words Satyajitambara, because Lord Chidambarasura Nataraja, who is involved in the cosmic dance. And very beautifully, you related the approach between Ekagi and Nanatva, and between even Madhusudana Saraswati's approach to the Advaita on one hand, elsewhere, where when he says, Krishnate Param Kimepi Tattva Maham Na Jane, how to reconcile between the two. And very beautifully you developed this idea of Shiva, Kartum Agartum Anjata Kartum Shaktaha, and who is a Karta? Because like Shiva is a Kavi, we said very beautifully, as we say in Sahitya, Apare Kavya Samsare Kavihi Ekaha Prajapati, he is the whole creator. And here it is Shiva who is a Karta, Bhokta Maheshwaraha. And that excellent interpretation of the word Uma, because most of the Sahityakaras are carried away by what Kalidasa has said, Uma iti matra tapasaha nishiddha. When she wanted to do penance, her mother Mena said, Uma, don't do this. Sirisha pushpam satisham tava vapuhu. So you cannot withstand this, therefore don't do this penance. But this interpretation as Omkara Shaktitvad Umeji Parikirtita. Very beautifully you have brought out, and the 9 differences between Shankara's interpretation and Abhinav Gupta's approach to this Advaita. It is a very marvelous lecture. I have no words to describe, really.
If anyone wants the reference, Yoga Vasishta Nirvana Prakaranam Uttarardha, chapter 84, verse number 11. So, Yoga Vasishta, Nirvana Prakaranam, Uttarardha, chapter 84, verse number 11. That is the Umeti Prakirtita, that verse.
Okay, fine.
Thank you.
Wonderful, sir. It was a wonderful exposition. We are indeed very, very fortunate to listen to you. In fact, I should say that it augurs well for the Kantal Shala, because this is the first of the series of lectures that has been commenced. And we are sure that you have put a very beautiful foundation for this, as the a scholar who delivered the first international commemorative lecture of Sri Shankara Jayanti. We are very, very, indeed, very fortunate. And before I just read out the citation, I request Professor Murali Madhavan to read out Swamiji's words of blessing. Swami Brahmananda Tirtha, Professor Murali Madhavan.
Thank you, Radhakrishnan. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes. Yeah.
Actually, I was very much astonished and what we call enthralled, as Professor Radhakrishnan has told. There is no words. That type of experience, of Advaitic experience, I am having hearing the lecture of the Professor Arindam Chakravarti. I composed a half of a verse about him. It is not full. Now it is only Dipadi. It will, Chadushpadi, it will become. But I will recite the first two verses I have composed now, hearing his lecture. Shastre Vistrada Shak, Vistrada Yukri Jala Jadile Nyaya Shastre. His special subject is Nyaya Shastra. Shastre Vistrada Yukri Jala Jadile Saundarya Saratmage Sahityecha Samam Vihara Chatura Pratnya Tava Anyadrishi. Shastre Vistrada Yukri Jala Jadile Saundarya Saratmage Sahityecha Samam Vihara Chatura Pratnya Tava Anyadrishi. Professor Chakrabarti ji, thank you for your scholarly presentation. Now, because of the paucity of time, I'm not talking much about his talk, because Professor Radhakrishnan has put in very, very brilliantly, he put in a nutshell the Sara of his lecture. Now I will read the message sent by His Holiness Swami. Hello.
ശങ്കര
ഭഗവത്പാദാഃ വൈശാഖ ശുക്ല പഞ്ചമ്യാം തിഥൌ ഭൂമാവതീര്യ നിഖിലാം ധരണീം സ്വാവതാരേണ പരിഭൂതാം അകാർഷുഃ ഏകൈകസ്യാപി അവതാരസ്യ സുനിശ്ചിതം ഏകൈകം വിശിഷ്ടമുദ്ദേശം ഉദ്ദേശ്യം ഭവതി തഥാ ചോക്രം ഭഗവതാ ഗീതാസു യദാ യദാ ഹി ധർമ്മസ്യ ഗ്ലാനിർഭവതി ഭാരത അഭ്യുത്ഥാനമധർമ്മസ്യ തദാത്മാനം സൃജാമ്യഹം ഇതി ജൈന ബൗദ്ധാദി നാസ്തികാനാം ഭൗതികവാദിനാം ച നിരന്തര പ്രവർത്തനേന അസ്തംഗതിതപ്രായാം വൈദികധർമ്മപദ്ധതിം ഉജ്ജ്വല ദീപിതാം കൃത്വാ പരാപ്രതിഷ്ഠ സമ്പാദനീയ ഇതിമേവ ഭഗവത്പാദാനാം അവതാരസ്യ ഉദ്ദേശ്യമാസീത് അത്യന്ത ഹ്രസ്വകാലീന മനുഷ്യജീവിതേന തൈഹി ലക്ഷ്യമിദം പ്രാപ്തം ച ഭഗവത്പാദാനാം ജീവനചരിതം അതിപ്രസിദ്ധം ഭവതി കേരളേഷു പൂർണാനദീ തീരസ്ഥ കാലടി ഗ്രാമേ ശിവഗുരോഃ ആര്യാംബായാം ജന്മലാഭം ബാല്യേ എവ പിതുഃ ശിവഗുരോഃ ദിവംഗമനം മാതൃലാളനയ വൃദ്ധിഃ ഏകദാ നദ്യാം സ്നാനകാലേ ഗ്രാഹഗ്രഹണാത് മോചനാർത്ഥം മാത്രാ സന്യസ്തം അനുജ്ഞാദാനം നർമ്മദാ നദീതീരെ ഗോവിന്ദ ഭഗവത്പാദ ആചാര്യ ദർശനം തൈഹി ശിഷ്യത്വേന സ്വീകാരഃ വാരാണസി പുരപ്രാപ്തിഃ ചണ്ഡാല വേഷധാരിണ ശ്രീപരമേശ്വരേണ സമാഗമഃ വേദവ്യാസ അപദേശേന ഉപദേശേന ആകാശ്മീരം പര്യടനേന ഭാഷാ പ്രസാരണേന അദ്വൈത വേദാന്ത സ്ഥാപനം സർവജ്ഞപീഠ ആരോഹണം ഏവം ദ്വാത്രിംശത് വർഷപര്യന്തം ഭഗവദാദേശേന അദ്വൈതതത്വം പ്രസാര്യ അന്തേ ബദരികാശ്രമേ ബ്രഹ്മണി വിലയപ്രാപ്തിഃ ഇത്യേതത് സർവം ലോകപ്രസിദ്ധം ഭവതി സംക്ഷേപതഃ ഇത്ഥമുച്യതേ അഷ്ടവർഷേ ചതുർവേദി ദ്വാദശേ സർവശാസ്ത്രവിത് ഷോഡശേ കൃതവാൻ ഭാഷ്യം ദ്വാത്രിംശേ മുനിരഭ്യഗാദ് ഇതി വിവേകചൂഡാമണ്യാദി പ്രകരണഗ്രന്ഥാഃ ബഹൂനി സ്തോത്രാണി ഇത്യേവം ब्रह्मसूत्र भाष्यादि प्रौढ़ प्रस्थानत्रय भाष्यम इति ग्रन्थाः आचार्यस्वामिभिः विरचिताः न केवलं स्वकृतग्रन्थैः स्वजीवितैरपि विज्ञेयानि तत्त्वानि आचार्यः लोकान् पाठयामास दुःखितेषु करुणा प्रदर्शनीया तद्दुःखनिवारणार्थं यत्नः कर्तव्यः इत्येतद् भगवत्पादाः ब्रह्मचर्य आश्रमवेलायामेव अध्यापयामासुः एकदा बालशङ्करः भिक्षापात्रमादाय कस्यचन गृहद्वारं प्राप भिक्षारूपेण किमपि दातुम् अक्षमा तत्रत्या गृहिणी अश्रुमुञ्जन्ति शुष्कम् आमल फलं वटोः भिक्षापात्रे निजिक्षेप वडुः अयमस्याः दुरवस्थां विलोक्य तत्कालं रचितेन महालक्ष्मी स्तुतिपरेण कनकाधारा स्तोत्रेण देवीं प्रसादयामास अंगं हरे कुळगभूषणमाश्रयन्ति भृङ्गाङ्गनेव मुकुळाभरणं तमालम् अङ्गीकृता किल विभूतिरभा अभाङ्गलीलामाङ्गल्यदास्तु मम मङ्गलदेवतायाः प्रसन्ना च देवी सुवर्ण आमलगीफलैः गृहं पूरयामास इति कथा प्रसिद्धा खलु आबाल्याद् आचार्यस्वामिनः करुणामयाः आचार्यस्वामिनः करुणामयाः आसन्निधि इत्येतत् कथया अनया गम्यते सर्वैः भक्तिस्नेह आदरपुरस्सरं माता पूजनीया इति स्वजीवितेन आचार्यः प्रदर्शयामासु मातुः स्नानसौकर्यार्थं नद्याः प्रवाहगतेः परिवर्तनं ते चक्रुः सन्यासिनोऽपि ते मातुः जीवितान्तकाले अवसानकाले गृहं प्राप्य परिचर्याम् अकुर्वन् मातुः जीवत्यागानन्तरं मातृपञ्चकमिति प्रसिद्धं स्तोत्रं रत्नं तैः रचितमासीत् आस्तान्दावधियं प्रसूतिसमये दुर्वारशूलव्यथा नैरुच्यं तनुशोषणं मलमयी शय्या च सांवत्सरी एकस्यापि न गर्भभारभरणक्लेशस्य यस्याक्षमो दातुं निष्कृतिम् उन्नतोऽपि तनयः तस्यै जनन्यै नमः इति श्लोकं कृत्वा साष्टाङ्गप्रणामान् समर्पयामासुः स्वकृतग्रन्थैः आचार्यैरुपदिष्टाः पाठाः श्लोकार्थेन इत्थं सङ्गृहीताः भवन्ति ब्रह्मसत्यं जगन्मिथ्या जीवो ब्रह्मैव नापरः इति ब्रह्म एक एव सत्यं जगत् मिथ्या जीवब्रह्मणोः न भेदः किन्तु ऐक्यमेव इत्येवं त्रीणि तत्त्वानि अद्वैतवेदान्तशास्त्रस्य सारभूतानि इमानि तत्त्वानि न केवलम् उपदिष्टानि परन्तु युक्तियुक्तं साक्षेप निरासं प्रसाधितं भगवत्पादैः एवञ्च ते भारतीय दार्शनिक आचार्येषु उत्कृष्टतमं स्थानम् अवापुः अनन्तरं च वैदिकदर्शनप्रतिष्ठानार्थं प्रचारार्थं च मठान् स्थापयामासुः स्वशिष्येषु प्रमुखान् एकैकस्य मठस्य अधिपतिं चक्रुः एवम् अत्यल्पेन जीवितकालेन बहूनि उत्कृष्टकर्माणि श्रीशङ्करभगवत्पादाः अकुर्वन् अत एव अद्यापि सर्वे जनाः तान् भक्त्यादरपुरस्सरं स्मरन्ति प्रणन्ति च भगवत्पादशिष्यैः पद्मपादाचार्यैः पञ्चपादिकायाम् आरम्भे एव निबद्धं गुरुवन्दनात्मकं श्लोकम् उद्धृत्य भाषणमिदं समापयामः नमाम्यभोगपरिवारसम्पदं नमाम्यभोगपरिवारसम्पदं निरस्तभूतिम् अनुमार्थविग्रहम् अनुग्रहम् उन्मुदितकाललाञ्छनम् विना विनायकम् अपूर्वशङ्करम् इति शम् नौ ऐ वाण्ट् टु मेन्शन् टु थिङ्ग्स् दट् द प्रोफेसर् सि एस् राधाकृष्णन् is a member of our academic advisory board, and also Professor Srinivas Varkedi, the vice chancellor of the Kavikula Guru Kalidasa University. He is also another very significant member of our academic body, academic council. So it is not academic council. That is a group of professors and like that. This is the highest body as far as academic advisors are concerned. We take advices from them. Our first meeting is over and second meeting is yet to we have to finalize the dates. And now these two scholars, they have witnessed the entire program, how the Kandalur Shala, we want to organize very seriously the academic programs, not for any show, not for any other this thing. We want to do it very seriously and we want to start it with a very serious scholar. And this this function, mainly this lecture of Professor Arindam Chakravarti, I want to say that it was an intellectual feast. Vibhava Sakdhi, Vijnana Sakdhi, Asmabhi Aswadita. So now with these observations, I beg to remain. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Murli Madhavan. Vai Mativa Danyaha Swami Padanam Anugraha Bhashanena. Now I will just read out the citation of Professor Arindam Chakravarti as per the schedule of the program. Professor Arindam Chakravarti is trained in both contemporary Western philosophy and classical Indian logic of the Nyaya school, in Indian aesthetics and Buddhist epistemology. His undergraduate training was in Presidency College, Calcutta, and his DPhil is from Oxford University, where his work was supervised by Michael Dumas and Sir Peter Strawson. After teaching for several years in the UK and the US, he returned to India in 1993 to take up a professorship in philosophy at the University of Delhi. Since 1997, he has been at the University of Hawaii. Between 2018 and 2020, he occupied the Nirmal Agastyanamattu Chair in Indic Humanities at the Department of Philosophy, Stony Brook University, New York. He has edited or authored 14 books in English, Sanskrit, and Bengali, and has published more than 100 papers and reviews in refereed journals or anthologies. In 2019, Bloomsbury London published his largest work, Realisms Interlinked, Objects, Subjects, and Other Subjects. Currently, he is finishing his contracted book with the Penguin Random House India, The Book of Questions, Indian Philosophical Analysis. A larger book on the moral psychology of emotions is in the pipeline. An earlier book in Bengali, an original work on the philosophy of body, food, and clothing is currently being translated for a Columbia University Press translation series. In 2019, the Sanskrit College and University in Calcutta conferred the degree of Mahamahapaubhadhyaya on Professor Arindam Chakravarti. It is a matter of pride for the Kandalur Shala that the first international lecture on Sri Sankara Jayanti Utsava is delivered by Professor Arindam Chakravarti, and the Kandalur Shala takes pride in honoring Professor Arindam Chakravarti with his title that he is a Vyakhyana Chakravarti. So, and he's not only a Vyakhyanadaha Vishesha Pratipatti, Shastratnyana very beautifully explained how Sarvatnyaha, Sarvaha Nyahata. It is not Sarvam Janati, but it is also Sarva and Jnya. So that such Vyakhyana, it comes with only profound knowledge of all the Shastras, and we are indeed very fortunate to listen to him, that he come up with the first lecture series was inaugurated by him, and the Kandalur Shala takes pride in honoring a great scholar, Professor Arindam Chakravarti. Thank you.
Go to the next program.
The next is honoring Professor Srinivasa Varkedi. The citation will be read by Professor Sri Madhava Nambudiri.
Very good morning. Madhava Nambudiri. Namaskara to all Gurujanas here. Namaskar. I am Madhava Nambudiri. Srinivasa Varakhedi, born to Hanumanta Varakhedi and Srimati Bharati in 1973 and Vidwat Mathima degree in 1995 and Vidwat Uttama postgraduate degree in 1997 in Navya Nyaya from Purna Prachna Sanskrit College of Bangalore. Then he acquired BA, MA in Sanskrit, and MA in Sanskrit Darshana, and then PhD Vidya Vairithi in Nyaya, in the application of Navya Nyaya Technical Language in Modern Technology Age, a study under Professor Haridasa Bhatt in 2004. He started his career in 1997 as lecturer in Purna Prachna Vidya Pitha at Bangalore and was elevated to Vice Chancellor of Kavikul Guru Kalidas Sanskrit University at Ramtak in Maharashtra. He is also acting Vice Chancellor of Gondwana University of Gadchiroli. His main research area is natural language processing while being an eminent scholar in Vedanta and Nyaya. He was visiting professor to several universities and guiding research fellows. He was awarded Maharshi Badarayan Vyas Samman by the President of India for the contributions to the interdisciplinary field involving Sanskrit in 2007. Other institutions honored him include Chinmaya International Foundation Shodha Sanstha in Kerala, Sri Periyaya Puttige Matha Udupi, Sri Ramanuja and Bhashyakara Trust Mantralaya Matha Kumbhakonam, Sri Palimaru Matha Udupi, Vejavur Matha Udupi, and Sri Raghavendra Swami Matha Mantralayam, Kunjuni Raja Academy of Indological Research, etc. Okay. He authored several books and contributed chapters to various books and edited various books and journals and published around 30 research papers in prominent journals. He started Sanskrit month celebrations during Shravana month in Karnataka Sanskrit University during his tenure as acting vice chancellor, started MPhil and PhD courses and structured syllabi of all courses and introduced new patterns for examinations in Karnataka Sanskrit University during his tenure as Director of Postgraduate Studies and Research. The entire system of traditional Sanskrit education was brought under one umbrella and revamped syllabus and designed new textbooks and implemented in schools while he was the first Director of Directorate of Sanskrit Education in Karnataka State. He, with the support of senior faculty members, could design and implement interdisciplinary courses in Sanskrit computational linguistics in Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeetha at Tirupati. Automation of examinations in Rashtriya Sanskrit University in Tirupati, revival of Sanskrit Academy at Osmania University, development of e-contents in Sanskrit for internet, development of Sanskrit computational linguistics, etc., are some other areas he contributed. Presently, as the Vice Chancellor of the Kavikul Guru Kalidas University, Dr. Varakhedi is all set to enhance the quality of education with the curriculum and with the imparting methods coupled with modern technology. With all his grace, he is very helpful to the establishment of Kantalur Shala and is on our academic advisory board, as already pointed out by Dr. Murali Mathur. We are grateful, sir, that you have given top priority to the activities of Kantalur Shala and inaugurated this international Sri Shankara commemoration lecture that was elegantly delivered by Professor Arindam Chakraborty. We pray that you be on the lead and guide us to fulfill the aims of Kandalur Shala. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, Madhavan Nambudiriji. Now I request Dr. Pradeep Jodi, the treasurer of the Kandalur Shala, to propose the vote of thanks.
Good afternoon, all. As all good things come to end in life, so is the today's session. On behalf of Kandalur Shala, I take this opportunity to propose a vote of thanks to those who have directly and indirectly contributed to this first academic event, International Sri Shankara Commemorative Lecture, instituted by Kandalur Shala as part of Sri Shankara Jayanti celebrations. At the outset, I thank the chief guest, our most beloved and respected and highly reputed scholar of international repute, Professor Arindam Chakraborty of Honolulu University, USA, for delivering the first Sri Shankara commemorative lecture, who took out valuable time of his busy schedule, and that too in the late night, as the time in Hawaii, USA is about 10:30 p.m. Sir, your explanation about the Vedanta from Kerala to Kashmir, comparing Sri Shankara's and Abhinava Gupta's Advaita is truly exemplary. We are really honored with your great presence, and at the same time, we are enlightened with your words of wisdom and knowledge. Thank you, Professor. We look forward for more such interactions in the coming years. It is indeed an honor to welcome you to Kerala, the God's own country, the birthplace of Sri Shankara, after the COVID pandemic intervention breaks, as our special guest. Thank you once again, sir. We are fortunate to get a young scholar of great respect and international repute, Professor Srinivas Varakedi, the Vice Chancellor of Kavikula Kalidasa Sanskrit University, Maharashtra, who inaugurated the first academic event of Kandalu Shala. We are happy and proud to state that he is also a member of our academic advisory board, as mentioned by the Professor Murli Madhavan. Thank you, Professor, for your scholarly words and advice. Let me also thank the chairman of today's session, a Vedic scholar of international repute, Professor P.C. Murli Madhavan, who is also the special officer of Kandalu Shala, who took pledge today in our presence. He is a man of wisdom and action, who works very hard and with utmost sincerity and devotion to revive Kandalu Shala. His dream is to build an institution with a blend of tradition and modernity for the humanity. Thank you, sir, for your leadership, and we are all with you to realize your dream.
Thank you.
We would like to thank our chief patron, His Highness Tiruthur Parameshwara Brahmananda Tirtha, the 48th Madhadipati of Muncharamadam Swami, who blessed us with his message. We also express our sense of gratitude and appreciation to our academic advisory board member, Professor C.S. Radhakrishnan of Central University of Pondicherry, who acted as a host and the master of ceremony for the smooth conduct of today's session. Thank you, Professor, for your valuable time and advice.
Thank you.
A good start and right beginning always assures success. Today, the meeting started with the Vedic invocation by two professors of Sri Sangharacharya Sanskrit University, Kaladi, Dr. Preeti and Sri Vinod. Thank you, professors, for the auspicious beginning. We are thankful to our Honorable President Sri Narayanan Putti, Vice President Sri Madhavan Nambudri, Secretary Subramanian Musad, Academic Director Dr. Ramamurthy, Administrative Director Dr. K.K. Hariharan, and all trustees and officers of Kandalu Shala and Sabha for their unflinching support and cooperation. We would like to thank all the participants for attending today's virtual session. We hope you had enriched with more knowledge, and we look forward to seeing you at the next session tomorrow. It is termed as Veda Vaibhavam. At 11 a.m. at the virtual platform. We truly appreciate your support. With this warm words, we move to the end of today's session. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we are dispersing, and our Kandalu Shala Executive Committee will meet today by 7:30 for a half an hour.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay.